Good morning, ma'am. First of all, I thank you for giving me an opportunity to introduce myself. I am Vanishree. I am from Tirupathur. I have done my MCA MPhil in Secured College at Tirupathur. Besides, I have completed my BEd at Salem. I have 5 years of teaching experience as an assistant professor. First, I have started my teaching career in Islamia College. From the academic year of 2015 to 2016 in the Department of Computer Science. Then I moved to Don Bosco College. There I worked as an assistant professor from the academic year of 2016 to 2020 in the Department of Computer Science. I handled digital logic paper, computer networks, data communication networks, programming in C, and .NET for PG students, and COA for UG, then DAA paper, which means design analysis and algorithm paper for UG students. And I handled JavaScript, CSS, HTML to other department students and UG students. Okay, and mentoring. So I'm a good mentor, I'm a good teacher, and I motivate a student to study well. And I make a student to improve technically. That's, and I love teaching, so I'm searching for online teaching jobs because right now I'm on maternity leave. So to enhance my teaching skills, I'm searching for online teaching jobs. And that's all about me. Okay. So today I'm going to take a demo class on algorithm. So algorithm. Algorithm means it has a set of rules to perform a task. Okay, so to perform a task, we need to set some rules, and we have to follow some steps to complete the task. That is the algorithm. Okay, so I'll give you one simple example which we use in our daily life. So the task is to make a cup of tea. That is our task. Okay. So to make a cup of tea, we have to follow certain steps. These steps is called as an algorithm, right? So step one, we have to add milk and water into a kettle, okay? And step two, once it has boiled, have to add tea leaves and sugar in it, right? And step three, once it has boiled and color has changed, we filter and serve it in a cup. Okay, so we follow some steps to make a cup of tea, right? So as like computer has some set of rules to perform a task. Okay, to perform any task, to perform addition of number, subtraction of number, multiplication of number, or to take a printout, whatever it may be. Okay, the computer, the machine needs some set of rules to perform its task. Okay, so I'll give you one definition for what is meant by computer algorithm. So computer algorithm is, it has a set of rules. Okay, it has a set of rules, obtain the expected output from the given input. Okay, in the compute, from the for computer, first we have to define input. Okay, once we have to given a, once input has been given, we have to expect the output from the given input. Okay, so it has to computer algorithm as a set of rules, it obtain the expected output from the given input. This is a definition for computer algorithm. Okay, so I'll tell you, first we have a set of input. Okay, then we have to perform some task. From the input we will get a output. That is computer algorithm. Okay, so I'll give you another example. To add two numbers, okay, to add two numbers, You should not sit in front of a computer and you should not ask a computer, computer, please print two numbers or please add two numbers. Okay? It won't take numbers individually or it won't give you the result. Right? We, the human being, have to define the inputs. Right? Human being have to enter number. Any number. 4. And another number is 4. Okay? Human being has to enter the number 4 and 4 and 4. Then the computer will print the result as a 8. Right? So, again I'll tell you the definition for a computer algorithm. The computer algorithm, it has a set of rules. It obtained the expected output from the given input. So, human has to give the input. From the input, the computer will give you the output. Okay? This is called as an algorithm. Okay? So, before start writing the algorithm in a computer, okay? So, first we have to follow some certain steps. So, first one is we have to define the problem. So, what is the problem? We have to define the problem. What is the problem? So, for example, the problem is sum of two numbers. Okay? The next step is requirements. So, what are the requirements? We need to add numbers. So, we need two numbers. Right? And for two numbers, we have two variables, right, A and B, and to get an output, we need another variable, that is C, that is requirement. Then we start designing. So A plus B equal to C, that is start designing. And next one is testing phase. So we have to test A equal to 2, B equal to 2. So C has to get the output as 4. So whether it print 2 plus 2 equal to 4, whether we have to test whether 2 plus 2 equal to 4 is correct or wrong. We have to define, we have to test, okay, sorry, we have to test, right? And last one is we stop the algorithm, okay? So we have to follow some certain step before start writing the algorithm, okay? So next one is it has some characteristics. So algorithm has some characteristics. So first one is, as already I said in the definition, first we have to take an input. Okay, so without input we won't get output. So first one is we have to take input. Next one is must we have to get output from the given inputs. So from the given input we have to get output, that is second step. And third one is the instruction must be clear. So we have to give a clear instruction to the computer. So for example, if we are adding sum of two numbers, so A plus B equal to C. So that is a clear instruction. If we give A and if we change the operator as minus, A minus B, we should not get addition of numbers. Okay, so the instruction must be clear. We have to give a clear instruction. And next one is it has a finite number of steps. So the steps must have a certain number. The steps should not go long. Okay, we have to write algorithm with a finite number of steps, which makes the process simpler. Okay, that is finite number of steps. And fifth one is the instruction must be clear. We have to give a clear instruction. That is the characteristics of an algorithm. Okay. And so from an algorithm, what we can expect from an algorithm? First, we expect correctness. So we get a correct output, which means correct result. And sometimes it produces an incorrect answer. Okay, because as I said, if you're adding a number of adding two numbers, if we give if you change the operator, instead of plus, if I give minus, the answer is 0. Okay, I could not get 2 plus 2 equal to 4. If I give an operator correctly for addition of numbers, 2 plus 2 equal to 4. If the mistake in from human side, I gave 2 minus 2, I could not expect result as 4. It give a wrong answer as a 0 because the mistake is done by the human. Okay, that is second. And third one is, we will get approximation of result. So we will not get exact result, but we are near, which we will get an optimal solution. That is third. Okay, we can expect from an algorithm third. And last one is, it occupy a less resource. Okay, it occupy less time and less space. Okay, so we expect four things from an algorithm. One is correctness, and second one is performance of a wrong answer because of human mistakes. Third one is, we'll get a approximation of a result, and fourth one is less occupation, which means we'll occupy only a algorithm will occupy only a less space and less time. And advantages of an algorithm is, it is solution, and disadvantages, for a branching and looping, it's difficult to write an algorithm. Okay, so thank you. That's all about a small introduction about an algorithm.